On hot copy this morning, Pia Cayetano placed fourth in the senatorial race with over 19 million votes based on the latest tally. Her brothers, former Foreign Affairs Secretary Alan Peter and Lino, were also proclaimed earlier as Taguig City First District Representative and Mayor respectively, while Alan Peter's wife Lani also got proclaimed as Representative of the Taguig Second District. Are the Cayetanos building a new political dynasty, and what can we expect from returning Senator Pia Cayetano? Watch our interview. Congratulations to you. So I should say Senator Pia Cayetano. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, well, first of all, this is not new to you. You've already sat in two consecutive terms.
Yes.
And you were always known as a women's champion in those two terms. Returning to the Senate, what will be your priority?
Well, the work that I've done in the Senate in the 12 years is really on education, health, women and family. So magkakasama lahat 'yon. I would like to believe that I've been a champion in all of those laws. But if you look at the number of laws, it's actually education where I passed the most number of laws. But all three are very important to me. And I've also championed the vulnerable sector, like PWDs, senior citizens, because I also chaired the Committee on Social Justice.
Yeah.
So if you ask me kung saan ang comfort zone ko, what areas I feel I have a level of expertise, those would be the areas.
Yeah.
But I'm a student of the law. I'm trained to study. So even though they are not my areas of expertise, I get involved with it. Like, for example, syntax. No, I'm not a tax lawyer, but I study.
Yeah.
So I got involved in it to the extent that I was protecting the health interests in syntax. Mm. So ganun lang naman. People can expect that I will study every measure.
Okay. Now, during the campaign, what's interesting is your track record would speak for itself in terms of what you've done for women. I mean, the extended maternity leave for women, the RH law.
Yes.
This was your first term or second term as senator?
I started RH law in my first term, but we actually dealt with it on the floor in my second term.
Okay. So imagine, RH law, the extended maternity leave for women, that's expanded to 105 days, Magna Carta for women, responsible parenthood. I mean, you can name it. We can go through this. And yet, during the campaign, you had to fend off criticism that you were a pretender in terms of being a women's champion. Let's talk about this a bit, because there was a period that seemed difficult for you when women's groups were criticizing that you weren't standing up against President Duterte's comments against women.
Actually, I don't think it was women's group who were criticizing me. I worked very closely with Gabriela. I have never heard them criticize me because they know the work I do.
Uh-uh.
I'd like to say, Karen, and I just mean this in all and all, people who follow the work that we do closely know that I have never faltered, I have never wavered in the fight for women's work, for women's rights, never,
yeah,
ever. Except that if you pull things out of the statements of the president and suddenly it becomes my responsibility, that's not fair.
Yeah.
That's not a fair criticism on me, diba?
Yeah.
Because I've never changed what I believed in. I've never changed what I've fought for. And women's groups know this.
Yes.
So yun lang naman yun. It just so happens that I am the type, and I think you have seen this, whatever, like for example, syntax, narinig mo bang maingay ako dyan? No, I just do my work. So when we talk about the tax implications on cigarettes, the graphic health warnings, that was a very highly lobbied issue. I just do my work. So ganito din ako. Masakit man na ginaganon ako because I don't believe it is a fair criticism of the work that I do. It is what it is,
Yeah.
I'm in politics, ganun talaga yon. But what I try to do every occasion I have is to talk about my work.
Yeah.
Because it is,
yeah,
it is my work that people should hold me accountable for. Not what other people say, not what other people do, but what I say and what I do.
Yeah, because there was a period that they expected you in a way, I went through some materials and, there was a period where you said boys will be boys. They criticize you for becoming silent on President Duterte's comments against women, comments on rape, etc., legs. And it was, it's so strange though that it was really all put on you when there.
Well, even this discussion, Karen, this discussion, when you go on your Instagram later, because you take this up, this will be the discussion. And that's why if people say, why do you choose to veer away from other things? It's precisely because it will revolve around these statements. I used to always say, you know, the problem with my work is, it's not pang headlines eh. My work is boring. This part of it becomes, makes it exciting because people want me to comment. People want to hear my reaction, yeah, diba? Yeah. But that's not the work I do. The everyday work I do involves tons of paperwork that I have to go through that no one will go through if I don't look at those data, diba? Yeah. And just very quickly lang, on the boys will be boys, that has ever since been taken out of context. It was a very candid discussion with sila Gang Badoy, where Gang was telling that she grew up with her brothers, all boys. And I said naman, me, although I grew up with brothers, my brothers kasi are not bastos eh. They're not like that.
Yeah.
Pero I live in a paradigm where it's a world created by men, which is basically the Senate.
Yeah, yeah.
And so sabi ko, boys will be boys because sila, ganun sila magsalita.
Yeah.
I'm stating a reality if that's how they talk. Did I ever say that that's okay with me? No. Eh, lumaki nga ako yung mga kapatid ko. You will never even hear my brother say, ay, sorry, sorry, nandiyan si ate. Because they don't talk that way.
Yeah, yeah.
That's how we were raised.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm just saying na suddenly I enter this paradigm na puro lalaki and I realize na lumalabas sa mga bibig ng mga lalaki. Ganon.
Yeah.
Ganon. Puro ganon. So sabi ko, ganon pala talaga itong mga boys na to. Oh. And I have to keep on inserting my corrections. And the only, I'm just correcting that
impression.
Crazy impression that sabi ko, ganon pala
you were
sila.
Tolerant.
And I was saying that, you know, I cannot insert every second of the day. We eat together. I'm talking about my Senate colleagues. Every Yun lang yung pinapoint out ko. I'm on the floor defending breastfeeding. Tapos nagigigil sila kasi breast daw, dede daw, dede daw. Kinikwento ko lang na, oh my Lord, ganito yung mga boys.
Yeah.
But you know what, Karen? Uh-oh. I've realized, critics want to criticize it. Instead of looking at all the work that I've done for women, the reality that the president said in his speech during the rally, and I cannot quote ha, kasi those were his words.
Yeah.
Nako, pag nandyan si Pia, hindi ako makapagsalita kasi pinapagalitan ako.
But he did say
the
that.
The president said that.
Yeah.
Na, hindi ko ma-quote yung exact words lang,
yes.
But he said that.
Yeah.
So my point is, kita nyo, the president knows, I've always said, and I said in my interview with you before, that my job has to also show the young people that I also have to show respect for others.
Yeah.
So if I have a concern, I talk to the president directly.
Yeah.
I've said that repeatedly. So every time we go back to this, nagiging ito yung discussion. So I hope
but
naman...
But isn't the flip side also because you are really seen as the women's champion? That's also the flip side. So what happens when you're put in that, you know what I mean? That ideal. So you have critics that watch every single move, wrong response. I mean, it's almost like a Gloria Steinem in the Philippines.
But if you see my work and you ask the women, by all means, ask them. Ask the women I work with, in all humility, they say they know what I do and they say that they continue to look up to me for the work that I do.
Yeah. Diba? No, to mention, just to be fair, that's why I brought it up because your track record does really show that you've done the most for women. So the Magna Carta of Women, RH Act, that you had to go through so much for that, Foster Care Act, and of course with the Graphic Health Warning Act in cigarette packs.
That's the pictures on the cigarette
today,
packaging.
The National Health Insurance Act. So
the National Health Insurance is the predecessor now of the latest PhilHealth.
So later we'll talk about how you'll move to universal health care. But you were also active in the AIDS Policy Act, so to speak. And now you want a monthly compensation for the poorest housewives when you return. Is that correct?
No, actually, let me clarify that. I was asked, no? That's not a bill or a policy that I put forward.
Yeah.
That was a question posed to me if I will support a pending bill like that.
Okay.
And my response to that was, all over the world, that is a concern being raised now by women's advocates. And I'm one of them. I've attended these conferences where the work of women is not compensated. It is not included in GNP, in the computation. So if you think about it, let's say a husband and wife and the woman is the stay-at-home. Pero nowadays, pwede naman na lalaki. But the majority, it's the woman. No? And then you produce four children. Isa naging engineer, isa naging doctor, blah, 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 all contributing to the economy. But the women's contribution would be considered zero. So that's the question. How do you compensate? How do you validate the contribution of women? I don't know exactly what the answer is because in a developing country, everything counts. No, we're trying to support the pension of the senior citizens. So can we give to women? And the other thing that I don't want to create is this society where we're just relying on dole outs. I'm not into that. But on that note, I'm not saying that women should not be validated for the work they do at home because that is serious work. Uh-oh.
But so, you feel the 2,000 a month additional for housewives, considering there is conditional cash transfer,
I'm not going to comment on the amount. What I want to see is really what kind of support systems are we giving to the households in general, the poorest of the poor first. I believe in socialized socialized support.
Okay.
It's the same way I felt about education. I didn't believe in free education for all. I'm a believer of free education socialized. So the poorest of the poor, why not?
So
I'll give you an example. Alan and I, it's actually initiated by Alan 6 years ago. We have hundreds of beneficiaries. These are organizations or cooperatives where we give them a fund that they manage themselves, contra 5-6.
Okay.
So that's our way of uplifting the lives of these families. Something like that, if we can institutionalize this by way of a law. Kasi it's been super effective all over the country.
Uh-oh.
These are anywhere from tricycle drivers, vendors in the market, and in a way, they were my inspiration because when I went around the country, imbis na kung saan-saan ako pupunta, pinupuntan ko sila.
Yeah.
Because Alan put it in place like 6-7 years ago. Uh-oh.
So when you return to the Senate, what committee, I'm curious, would you like to handle?
Well, the committees that I chaired in the past were education, health, women and children, social justice, and environment.
That's a lot.
I've handled all those committees in the past.
Okay.
So all of those committees, I would be competent in handling.
What would be your first love?
I'd say education. Why? Because that's actually my battle cry during the campaign. So I have a commitment also to make that happen. And I'll tell you why. This is economic security, di ba? You've had so many guests who paint a beautiful picture of the Philippines' future, right? Magandang hinaharap natin. But we have to prepare the youth for these jobs. Like we're talking about all this, you know, shift to technology, all these big investors coming in. Is the youth ready? Are they ready for this kind of challenges? Are they being prepared? And honestly, there are gaps in their preparation.
Yeah.
So I want, if I can, and I'm not saying I'm the only one competent to do it, there are other senators who can, I'd really like to dig, you know, put myself in there and create those linkages. Because we've never really, if you ask the business community and they've been your guests, they'll all say, remember, there's this whole thing about not having skilled workers, this mismatch.
Yeah. It would be education.
Yeah. And just to something to plant in people's minds. A few years back, when I was the chair of the Committee on Education, I visited Singapore and I asked them, how do they match? You know, they actually put a cap on students that want to go to med school because they need only X number of doctors. Yeah. They'll put a cap because that's how they want to be sure that they can meet the needs, and wherever the needs are, that's where they...
I'm curious, you've also been a health advocate. I mean, it was quite bold to actually insist on the graphic warnings, frankly, on the cigarette packs. Huh?
Yeah.
So, I mean, kudos to you for that. But the universal health care, which the president wants to be full coverage, you know, people have... Well, it's not they're cynical with the president, but they're like, come on, we're a developing country. How can you make that possible?
Yeah.
Yan ang tanong ko sa'yo.
I can explain a bit. even during the version of the, well, the existing law now, kasi hindi pa naman yata nag-effective yan. The existing law now, I basically institutionalized what was already in the pipelines and put what the PhilHealth Board was putting together. Uh-oh. And basically, what happened there was, they came up with a list of, at the time, I think something like 15 top diseases that kaya nilang i-cover.
For free, completely.
And this is the zero balance.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, so ganun. So kunyari, appendicitis, zero balance na yan.
Uh-oh.
Because the studies then showed that the top 10 beneficiaries of PhilHealth were all private hospitals, which means this tagal na to. This means that those who are benefiting, which is a good thing, are the middle class and onward. I'm happy that the middle class can benefit, pero paano naman yung lower? Hindi sila makatungtong sa ospital. That's the point eh. So without that zero balance, they cannot even avail of any services, right?
Yeah.
Because they have nothing to contribute.
Uh-oh.
And that was why the objective was, little by little, we will grow those number of conditions, sicknesses, ailments that can be covered na zero balance.
Yeah.
So in that sense, yung universal, everyone is covered, but up to saan ba covered yan? Yun lang naman yung tanong dun eh. Lahat ba ng klaseng cancer you can cover? No, you cannot. Lahat ba ng klaseng children's preventable diseases? The answer there should be yes, because that is immunization. So all of these preventable diseases, and that is what killed me during the campaign. We're talking about health security. How can we talk about economic progress when we cannot even have health security for preventable diseases?
Yeah.
That's measles.
Uh-oh.
That was one of my very first laws, national immunization, mandatory immunization.
Uh-oh.
Mandatory, sorry for those who don't believe in immunization, but it is mandatory. The reason is, you put other children at risk when you decide that you do not believe in immunization.
Yeah.
And that is what happened.
Uh-oh.
What happened here was because of Dengvaxia.
Yeah.
The average Filipino mother who does not know about these controversies. Dengue is new, right? There was no dengue when we were kids. So even the vaccine for dengue was new. But what happened there was it created this scare among all the mothers, particularly the poor mothers, and they did not bring their children to be vaccinated.
Ang tanong ko ngayon, what about the health committee?
Would
you want that?
I would want it, but I would want that JV would win so that he can chair that health committee because he's good at his job.
Uh-oh.
And we have had lengthy talks about it. When I was in the house, I would message him, JV, pumasa na dito yung ganito. Bahala ka kasi hindi na correct ito.
Quickly, because this is your first interview after technically the win, it is still partial and unofficial.
Yeah,
but hey,
unofficial.
Were you surprised, frankly, with the top 12?
I'm never surprised na lang eh. Kasi when I ran the very first time, I was in the 20 plus. So I would also tell my colleagues who
20
were not
plus ka noon.
20 plus.
And you ended the first one.
Number 6.
Good rin.
And this was manual voting pa ha. Alam namin, feeling namin, kasi in the exit polls, I was number 4.
Yeah. But you mean to say, you're right, you were 20 plus, you made it to 6.
Well, there was one what do you call this survey just before election where I was number 11.
Yeah.
So isa lang yon.
Pero kinabahan ka.
No, sorry. Noon. From 20 plus,
okay.
Naging
11.
So natulog ako after voting, so I go, Lord, it's yours.
Oo.
So yun lang yon. So I was telling my colleagues, you never know. And that's why ako, kinakabahan din ako sa pag medyo, I think the lowest I reached was 5, but it was statistically tied 5 to 7. But on the average, I was number 3, 4, 5. Kinakabahan ako doon sa 5 to 7 because if you look at 8 to 12, which is what happened nga, it's all unclear.
Yeah.
You know, 8 to 15, we're all tied. So that's why I was really working doubly hard.
Your campaign strategy, well, you weren't the biggest spender in terms of ad.
No,
you were
malayo.
Not. But then you do campaign uniquely.
You bike
all over the Philippines.
And I hike. I go up mountains.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, but just even to bike to every barangay.
Hindi naman ko nag-bike every barangay. I wish.
But you did.
I couldn't bike as much as I wanted to because I had to cover more areas.
But,
if kung sa kaligayahan ko lang and makisama ako sa mga nag-iimbita sa akin mag-bike, I would have biked all
over. Yeah.
But yeah, I like to do that because number one, I get inspired. Like when I when I hike up a mountain or I bring my bike up a mountain trail and we get to this school where there's two classrooms there and it's integrated classroom, just like the Montessori school of my kids. So yeah. I tell the mothers, it's not a bad thing. Okay to na the young learn from the old. It's a matter of having a very good teacher and having enough resources, no? But then where's the high school? The high school is 2 hours away. Yon. So then I realize these things. I see it with my own eyes. Na, wow, at the age of 13, mahihiwalay, this child will not grow up with his parents anymore because he has to walk 2 hours to school and he'll have to dorm there. There's no dorm.
So yeah. Okay. Now, medyo Senate politics. If Cynthia Villar guns for the Senate presidency, I mean, right now the incumbent, of course, is Senate President Tito Soto. I mean, I want to ask you who you'll vote for, but you ran with Cynthia.
Well, Tita Cynthia's my party mate.
That's what I was going to say.
Yeah, because we're both nationalist party.
So that would be a given then? You would support her all out for the Senate presidency?
Well, she's my party mate, and I have a lot of respect for her. She's very strong-willed on the causes she believes in. So if she runs for the Senate presidency, obviously... I'm with her.
Yeah.
But I've never heard her talk about it, so...
Okay. When Cynthia was a guest on the show, I asked her, of course, about... There are just three of you, technically, that run under the party.
Yeah.
You, Amy, and Cynthia.
Yeah.
And I asked her, and I want to ask you this. How did you feel... I mean, of course, she's won, Amy Marcos. But with the whole allegations of dishonesty regarding her academics and educational background...
Well, in my case, kasi you know naman how strong I feel about academics, no? I've been a champion of education, and I feel that should be dealt with as sincerely as possible. Because here we are talking to the youth about the importance of education, and we do have issues pa rin yung ano yung nabibili sa recto.
Yeah.
So I do feel that issue should be resolved and dealt with candidly and not brushed aside.
So that's quite fair. That's all you're saying, no? Is you didn't discuss it during the campaign? Because I asked Cynthia, did you ever ask? I mean, did. That's her problem. Did you ever discuss it?
No.
No, not even.
I mean, that's for her to diba? So, but if you ask me, I will answer candidly as I have on how I feel about it.
Yes. Okay. All right. Is there such a thing as a good dynasty? I asked Cynthia this, and she said, we're a good dynasty.
Of course,
that got very controversial feedback, but she said, we're a good dynasty. You're already criticized, the Cayetano family, as a political dynasty in Taguig. Mm. Is there such a thing as a good dynasty, Pia?
I'll answer that question directly at the end of the statement I'm going to make. It's very simple. All over the world, you have people who are sons and daughters, grandchildren of former presidents. All over the world, the U.S., Russia, everywhere you go. And the same thing in the Philippines. And I've always said, judge a person by the work that they do, by their character. If you look at me and my siblings, the reality is we grew up with inspirational parents. Our father was a senator. He gave free legal advice for 10 years. Our mother was a teacher. I never wanted to enter politics. I ended up here. Do you think I love waking up to all the criticisms that you talk about, which, truth to be told, is... not fair, not
so you
not
get
even
hurt. You do
no,
get hurt.
My point is it's a job that I chose to do with all the that comes with it, okay? And we do it from the bottom of our heart because we genuinely believe in change. In my Instagram post, which you liked yesterday, I said this simply. My lawmaking skills, and this is my pitch for people who are also criticizing those who humbly say that there should be a seminar. No, there is a seminar. Senator Flavier, when I entered the Senate, handed me a handbook which he made on parang lawmaking 101. He's my seatmate, and I learned so much.
There
is a seminar because Senator Flavier was a doctor, a great doctor, a secretary of health. I was a lawyer. I graduated with honors. But do I know the ins and outs? No, because you have to become an expert in various things. And maybe to a certain extent, I was knowledgeable about corporate law, about family law. But I didn't work for my father. Yeah. So I didn't know the ins and outs. So you have to learn. So I always say that lawmaking gave me the skill I need to write laws, no? So, and the confidence when I ran, because I had no political background the first time,
yeah,
the confidence to know that I can do this job. I could look people in the face and say, I can do this job because I am a lawyer. But what is the heart and soul of my laws? The heart and soul comes from who I am. And at the time I ran, I was a woman who had just lost a child. Yeah. I had lost my son. I went through the debilitating illness of my father, something that many people go through. I'm not the only one, hindi ako feeling, but I'm saying, alam ko yun, na mawalan ka ng magulang, na maubos yung pera, yung pinundan ng tatay ko, because he had a liver transplant in the US. So alam ko yun. Fast forward, baka sabihin nila, oh, but that was the past, yeah, but fast forward, I became a solo mom. Then I became an adoptive mom. I have natural born children. Yes. I have an adopted son. So all of these things help me create these laws that I make, right? And I also am good at listening. You'll hear me just listening and watching. And I also learned that from Senator. I've had so many good mentors. Senator Miriam Defensor, Senator Joker Arroyo. Sometimes he would say to me, I'd be writing, he'd say, Pia, baba mo yung pen mo, makinig ka. Do you understand why these two people are debating? Sabi ko, yeah, it's about whatever the topic was. He's like, no, that's not it. May tampuhan yan, dalawang yan. Kaya nag-aawa. So you know what I mean? So what was my point? My point is,
yung good dynasty. Yeah. Yun muna, you made that, yes.
So going back to that point.
Yeah, first.
Going back to that point, I always say, look at the qualifications of the people who are running. Our mayor of Taguig City has been a barangay captain.
Lino.
Yeah. Has been deputy minority floor leader and fought for issues on the floor in his short 3-year term. And he's now the mayor. Very successful in his own personal life and his business. I am so freaking excited for his term. Kargahin na namin yung bansag na good dynasty. Pero let my brother prove himself because I will be waiting on the sidelines clapping for him every moment
of the
day.
It seems to me you're really more excited about Lino than, I mean, Alan and Lani won too.
Okay, I'm very excited for Lino because the mayor's position is so important, di ba? That's why I'm excited ako for Lino. Uh-oh. But we always say that Lino's taking off from the foundation that Lani built. Mm. Ibang level. I'll give you an example. People don't realize that basura is still a problem in Metro Manila. You know, for 9 years, patawarin, Alan said, he cannot ride in peace in the car with Lani because lahat yan, may isang basura, tigil kayo. Oy, bakit kayo may basura dito? Ganun klaseng mayor si Lani. Uh-oh. And I know that Lino will be the same.
Did it make you uncomfortable when they decided to run in two different districts? I mean, you know it was in the news.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So, but I mean, in the family that you
number
discuss
one,
it?
I'm oblivious to all this. Yeah, okay? Yeah. So when people think, do we plan this thing? No, we don't. Well, obviously, mag-asawa sila, so they talk about it. I don't. I have my own life. I have my own kids to worry about. I have my own work. Yeah. So I just found out na ganun yung decision nila. Again, it's something that we have to deal with, di ba? That's one more Cayetano in the political arena. But the thing is, I'm proud of each one of them. So if we have to deal with this, we'll deal with it.
Yeah.
And we'll deal with it individually because each one of us will prove ourselves in the work that we do.
Now, this is leading to a bigger question in lawmaking.
Mm.
Okay, first, under the federal draft constitution, because some say that President Duterte might now have a better chance of pushing federalism in the next 3 years, there is an anti-dynasty provision.
Mm.
And yet many politicians don't believe in the anti-dynasty provision. In fact, they say the term limits promote the proliferation of political dynasties because if you're a good candidate, mm-hmm. you're good at your job, but then you have to stop. You're forced to have, let's say, your wife run. Mm-hmm. So without term limits, if you can do the job, then you're like in the U.S., mm-hmm. right?
Yeah, if you can do the job well,
then it's you.
Yeah.
Ang tanong ko, if this is discussed, where will you be with the anti-political dynasty provision with federalism? Yeah.
Well, I was going to add this to the discussion, and I'll say it now. What the one thing I wanted to add into the discussion is this: the opportunity for women to acquire leadership roles, especially in the public sector. You'll either be appointed or you'll be elected. And for you to be elected, if you look at the women, they most likely will be the wife of an incumbent or the daughter of, like me. I was the daughter of, I am proudly the daughter of a former Senator Rene Cayetano. So actually, this allows women to shine. There are so many women members of Congress who are so good. And it's precisely because they had the ability to enter politics, if not through their husbands, through their father, through their brother. Mm-hmm. Because normally, it's still a job that is somehow reserved
for the men. Or may male bias. You mean male bias. So when a woman gets in, that's good. That's what you're saying.
So that's what I'm saying. So you know what? Why will you limit the opportunity for women to enter into politics by putting this political dynasty? Because that is a reality. Like it or not, a lot of women, and I'm not saying all entered through kamag-anak, no. But I'm saying most, even Cory Aquino was the wife of, GMA was the daughter of, Pia Cayetano is the daughter of. Eh, ganun eh. So I'm saying, I always submit my work. Judge me for my work. Don't judge me for who I'm related to. But the truth is, I'm so proud of the people I'm related to. By all means, bring it on.
So what you're saying, in effect, is yes, it opens the door, but please look at the track record. Yes, I think that's what you're saying.
That's what I'm saying.
No, the criticisms against Bato. I mean, I want to continue with that because when he said, oh, hindi may seminar ba dyan? Let's continue with that because you said meron.
Meron talagang seminar. Kaya you know what, people? Quit the being smart, Alex. People on social media, you know, you think you know it all.
I agree.
We don't. Even I don't. Even Karen don't.
I don't.
We don't know it all. So when Bato, and that is why people
loved him.
People love Bato.
Exactly.
People love the president because they're so candid. Bato freaking has a master's, right? In business
ad. And frankly, ad, PhD. And
PhD. My God,
PMA.
Bato.
Oh, he does. He has
Bawa
a PhD.
Bawa ko sa'yo, okay? But he conducts himself so candidly. He's one of the most humble person I know. So when he asked for a seminar, I didn't think twice about it. In fact, I was gonna say, I didn't see him yet. I was gonna say, one-on-one kita. Kasi I love talking about the law. One of my frustrations, Karen, is to be a law professor.
Oh, God.
That, sana Lord, in my lifetime. That's my frustration. So,
really?
Oh, I'm gonna volunteer. So there's nothing wrong about it. And then I even see this like, oh, but if you ever went to a doctor and your doctor said, may seminar, guys, it's totally different. Do you want all your senators to be lawyers? Good luck to us. I mean, kami lang, kung magdebate kami ni Alan, humahaba na yung buhok ko eh. Dalawa pa lang magkapatid yan. And I love my brother to death. Pero ang abogado, ibang, you don't want all of us to be lawyers. But if you ask me, well, then how do you become knowledgeable about the law? Well, then you become a lawyer. You don't want that.
You want different people in the
seminar. And you want people like Bato who will freaking attend the seminar. Because from what I recall, hindi nag-a-attend ng seminar ang mga tao.
Ay, yung iba?
Hindi nag-a-attend. Mag-a-attend staff nila. Kaya magagaling staff namin. Magagaling naman talaga.
But that's a revelation.
So, I actually have this vlog in the making which hindi ko matapos-tapos because nga I'm a stickler for details. And I'm putting there all my Latin maxims that I use when I make laws. Do you know, Karen, that when I make a law that says like, the following shall be excluded, and I list that, my staff and I, my chief of staff is standing right there. Naiiyak na sila sa akin kasi I keep saying, alam niyo, pag sinaman niyo yan, there's a rule, and I may say this wrong, excluso uno, excluso something else. It basically means, whatever you include, may exclude yung iba. That's a Latin maxim, which is a legal principle.
Yeah.
If you don't know that, then you might say, sige, example natin doon, eh, pero yung hindi mo sinama. And yun yung mga nakakarating sa Supreme Court kasi vague ang law na yan.
I see.
Who would know that? Yung mga katulad ko lang na nerd, na honor student sa law school, sorry, with all due respect,
but
pero ganon.
You're making a fair point in saying, this is what I'm hearing is, stop criticizing those who've won, who admit they don't know how to make a law.
Because only lawyers would really know. And even then, ang dami ko pang hindi alam. I took a year to listen carefully. How it works.
You're saying is what's more important is the one who won is interested to learn.
Yes. And the background shows that may capability to learn. May capability. Well, my gosh, somebody with a master's and a PhD obviously has so much absorptive capacity to learn many things.
Okay. Now, in 2008, you were one of the senators who filed a resolution. You can correct this. This was part of the research I read, seeking to convene Congress to a constituent assembly. Is that correct?
2008. Yeah. For what? For what purpose?
I think there may have been a discussion on charter change.
I'm trying to think.
Yes. But let's move forward because, okay.
Lala, sorry.
Okay. Would you vote for a constituent assembly if
for
it is,
what? For purpose
let's say of charter change.
Well, first of all,
this was a big controversy.
Let me fill you in.
Yeah.
I never really heard charter change being discussed during the campaign, ha? Is that a revelation? Uh-oh. I mean, just to put things up to speed. Mm-mm. If that was such an important topic, why wasn't it discussed? We haven't talked about it. I want to see before we even
comment.
Have me again as your guest, because honestly, it is not a priority that I have. I have always said, not vocally, but in small discussions, even as early as that initial, that was during the time of GMA, if that's what you're referring to, I really believed in electing the right public officials into office, people who are not corrupt, people who have a track record either in their private life or as policymakers in pursuing difficult. That's why mayabang ako, because naninindigan ako sa paniniwala ko. I want to see officials like that who can stand for what they believe in, because that is what will make change.
Okay. Do you think there should be a review of train?
A review of train. Well, I will also put on record, because I feel like my Senate colleagues, again, people, educate yourself. The world was, the whole world was experiencing the effects of inflation, of the prices of oil, the whole world. Yeah. So to pin that all on train was not fair. And every political advisor will tell their client, don't say that. Sabihin mo na lang na ipapareview mo. Sabihin mo na lang na i-repeal yan.
Yeah.
Because that is a politically correct thing to say.
But
any financial expert will tell you that this is happening all over the world. Now, does it mean you should be insensitive to the plight of the poorest of the poor because sila yung tinatamaan? No, you should not be. But you cannot pin it on a policy when the whole world is reeling from this policy or not. Because otherwise we don't elevate the level of discussion. You keep people in this then we'll just vote for these people who are willing to give us this catchphrase that feeds our desire for the moment for a quick fix. That's not the quick fix, because we are captive to that to that rise and fall of those prices.
So you're saying in effect train in the long run is good.
Train in the long run is good. Now, should we review it? Of course. Of course we should review it. That is our job. If every other month, kailangan namin balikan yan, that is our job, di ba? If meron kaming hindi nakita dyan na bigla pa lang may produce na ganito yung isang bansa and it's infiltrating us, what do we do? Do we protect our market? Let's be upfront about it. Do we protect our market or do we allow that to come in so that the general majority will benefit from the lower price?
Yeah.
We don't call a spade a spade. That's what it is, eh.
Okay. Now, the Senate is set to handle Endo. This has been a long journey from the president's campaign promises. Secretary Silvestro, Bello, tried at least to mitigate. Alam mo yon? I mean, you have so many big companies that have said they've already hired. But if in Endo, how do you interpret Endo to be? That's the tricky part about the Endo.
I have yet to see. Yeah. Well, I'm going to enter the Senate. I have no idea if in the next 3 weeks they'll have an opportunity to pass it. Yeah. So I'm the type that, because people ask me, how do you do all the things that you do? I am also a hands-on mom, Karen. So the way I do it is I choose my battles and I face the issue when I need to face it. So for now, hindi ko problema yung Endo right now only because it already passed the House. So what the final version in the Senate is theirs. If it doesn't pass, then it becomes my problem because we'll have to deal with it again. So until then, I don't know. Let's see.
Okay. Now, this is not a local issue, but I mean, being a women's advocate that you are, I know that worldwide, quite aware there's a whole discussion on abortion, legalizing abortion all over. Ano
it's
to?
All over the internet.
It's apparently. All over the internet.
And my daughters have brought it to. Can I just say, no. my daughters, I have two daughters in college. They brought it to my attention because they're like, "Mom, what is this whole concern of Filipinos? They follow basically Filipinos." About what's happening with abortion abroad when in the Philippines,
we
don't have abortion. So what is that? And I'm like, I don't know. I don't know because, I mean, it's nice that we're curious about what's happening, but I think you should bring the discussion here. So my daughters and I, we ended up having discussion that what would be the possible grounds. And I told them, I recall that there was a bill in the House allowing abortion if you were raped, to save the life of a mother, and there was a third. I couldn't remember what it was. So I'm just saying what these discussions were.
I mean, I'm curious. It doesn't mean you legislate it, but given the climate where we are and your personal, because you're quite progressive, frankly. So would you have been for that, if ever?
I honestly believe, and I call on all my colleagues to adopt this view because it is our legislative mandate to have an open mind on everything. You may have a close mind in your personal view, but especially if you chair a committee, you need to be able to listen to the stories. You need to be able to hear how will a mother carry a child where she was raped, or then I will listen to the other side. Well, then give it up for adoption. I want to listen, you know? So that's my position always. I will strive to always listen. And I've read all the books, huh? We are, our minds, we block it off, just like Facebook algorithms. We have our own algorithms. We refuse to listen. So I pray that us legislators, that we open our minds because we cannot move forward.
Yes, okay. As a women's champion to divorce, I've championed
that in the House. Yeah, no, but, we passed all the divorce bills in the House. I have.
So, but will you carry that on to
course.
The Senate?
Oh, that's my job. But and I am also a Christian, okay? I'm very vocal about it. I am a Christian. But it has been my job to look at the plight of women, and for that matter, even men, who have been in marriages that have ruined their lives. I mean, one very quick example. This woman in Hong Kong, she was practically sold by her mother to a richer family to be the wife of the spoiled husband. Yeah. And all her life, wala siyang ginawa kundi magtinda na para buhayin yung asawa niya. She finally becomes an OFW and even brings her daughters there. Her husband has another wife and other kids, and she's still feeding her husband.
With a new wife.
Even her daughters are like, "Mom, patawarin, let go." Sabi niya, "Hindi ko ma-let go hanggat hindi kami ma-divorce or ma-anal because asawa ko pa rin yan." These people want a divorce. These people need it, deserve. Uh-oh. So yun lang naman yung akin.
Yeah. No, because it's quite refreshing. It would mean that you will, I mean, in the Senate, you know how conservative many lawmakers are.
Yeah, but I pour my heart and soul out into the work that I do, diba? So that's my job.
Yeah. Okay, you've said in an interview you won't be a yes woman to President Duterte.
Naman, I mean, that's takot nga daw siya sa akin. Mr. President.
Because you did vote against the lowering age of criminal responsibility in the House.
Yeah.
You already did.
And may background yan, Karen, before the change in speakership, we had a committee report on that already. Yeah. And again, with all due respect to local government officials, marami sila and I love them to death, I know where they're coming from because ginagamit talaga yung mga bata ng sindikato. Uh-oh. Alam ko talaga, it's a tough decision because I know where they're coming from. And that's why I hate this like yes, no, yes or no ka. Because a lot of my colleagues were former mayors and governors. And ginagamit. So, it really requires a longer term solution.
Yeah.
And,
Okay. All right. Last words. You're going back to the Senate. What kind of Pia Cayetano are we expecting to see? Higher office. Have you ever thought of that?
I don't think of these things. Pinapasa Diyos ko lang yan.
Pati yung boyfriend.
Pati boyfriend, pati love life, I'm single. Malay mo, my future Prince Charming is watching us today. No, just kidding. On the lighter side. I fight for what I believe in, but I fight both quiet and loud battles. So there will be times that I do not talk about an issue yet Like even divorce, no, I do not want to offend people. Yes. I do not want this about to be about me and the church or me about and my colleagues. Mm-hmm. I have so much respect for my Christian colleagues. I'm a Christian too. Yeah. So that's why they might say like, oh, why isn't she fighting for it? Mm-hmm. Believe me, I am. Yeah. But I'm smart enough to know where to fight my battle. It might be in a conference room. It might be over coffee, mm-hmm. trying to explain my side. But I think my track record, and I ask the people to believe that when I say I will fight for something, I will fight for something.
On that note, Pia Cayetano, congratulations to you.